for your kind address. Now we will witness the foundation stone laying and dedication to the nation of 61 highway projects worth ₹5,592 crores and 1411 kilometer length by Honorable Minister for Road Transport and Highways and MSME Sri Nitin Gadkari ji. The function is presided by Sri Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy, the Chief Minister Andhra Pradesh, in the august presence of Sri General Dr. V.K. Singh ji, Sri D. Kishan Reddy Garu, and Sri M. Sankar Narayana Garu. May I now request the Honorable Minister, Road Transport and Highways, to unveil the plaque, which will be accompanied by screening of a short film on the projects. Sir, kindly.
Under the guiding light from the Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi and capable execution by the Minister of Road and Transport Sri Nitin Gadkari, ably supported by the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh Sri Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy, Andhra Pradesh is zooming fast on the track of success with the infra projects worth ₹15,592 crore. The land of Vijayawada is now witnessing the paradigm shift in growth with the completion of 2.5 kilometer long Kanak Durga flyover. This six-lane structure is built on the unique spine and wing structure and resting on a single pier, an engineering marvel. Underneath, it has a four-lane road, which will reduce the travel time from 30 to 45 minutes to just 5 minutes. Bend Circle is the heart of the city. And to ease traffic congestion, a six-lane flyover was envisaged. Now the day has come when three lanes are complete for dedication to the nation. Another three lanes are up for the Bhumi Pujan. The list doesn't end here. Andhra Pradesh is scheduled to get 28 ROVs under Setu Bharatam scheme. Today, two ROVs shall be handed over to the state near Chittoor. On this historic day, many more projects are being launched, and these are four-laning of Kadapa to Kurnool section of NH40, Vijayawada to Machilipatnam section of NH65, Nalagamapalli to AP Karnataka border section of NH4, six-laning of Ranasthanam to Anandapuram section of NH16, and two-laning with paved shoulder of Anandapuram to Kalyan Durg section of NH544DD. Guti to Tadipatri section of NH67 and Epparapalem to Ongal section of NH216. There are 15 more projects costing ₹6,385 crore lined up for execution and start of the work. These projects include construction of 6-lane Vijayawada bypass, including major bridge across River Krishna, with paved shoulders of several sections of national highways, construction of three ROVs under Setu Bharatam, construction of two bypasses and one flyover on other national highways. Additionally, 36 numbers of works on state roads are being started under CRIF scheme. Further, DPR for 25 port connectivity roads having a length of 404 kilometers at a total cost of rupees 7,000 crores has been taken up. This will give better connectivity to ports like Vishakhapatnam, Kakinada, Machilipatnam, Krishnapatnam under Bharatmala Sagarmala Pariyojana. This project shall usher the state of Andhra Pradesh into the new trajectory of growth and prosperity, spreading smile on the faces of its citizens.
बहुत-बहुत धन्यवाद, आभार सर. थैंक यू फॉर अनवेलिंग द प्लेक. Now may I request the Honorable Chief Minister Andhra Pradesh, the Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu, to make his address.
Shri Nitin Gadkari Ji, Honorable Union Minister for Road Transport and Highways and MSME, Shri General V.K. Singh Ji, retired, Honorable Union Minister of State for Road Transport and Highways, Shri G. Kishan Reddy Garu, Honorable Union Minister of State for Home Affairs, Shri A. Giridhar Garu, Secretary MoRTH, Shri Dr. Sukhbir Singh Sandhuji, Chairman NHAI, Shri I. K. Pandeji, Director General MoRTH, and my ministerial colleague, Shri Shankar Narayan Garu also. Respected public representatives and other dignitaries present in the virtual conference, participating in the Bhumi Puja of projects ready for foundation and dedication to the nation of completed projects in Andhra Pradesh. A very warm greetings to all of you. Under the visionary leadership of Shri Narendra Modi ji and our dynamic leader Shri Nitin Gadkari ji, with his visionary approach, has transformed the national highways infrastructure in the entire country by increasing the pace of construction of national highways from 12 kilometers per day in way back in 2013-14 to around 30 kilometers per day as of now.
Honorable Chief Minister, Jagan Mohan Reddy ji, my cabinet colleague Kishan Reddy ji, my colleague Honorable State Minister General V.K. Singh ji, Minister of Road and Building, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Sri M. Shankar Narayana ji, all the Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Member of Parliament, MLAs, and all brothers and sisters. It is a pleasure for me. Today we are marching ahead for the development of new infrastructure in Andhra Pradesh. And that is really a great pleasure and pride for me. Before our government, up to 2014, the total NH in Andhra Pradesh was 4,193 kilometers. Now, till May 2020, it comes to 6,860 kilometers. It is the length of national highway in Andhra Pradesh before. The increase in it is 2,667 kilometers. That is 64% in the 6 years. Regarding the expenditure also, the total sanction accorded since 2014 was 32,250 crores and total expenditure coming up to 24,225 crores. The work costing rupees 8,869 crores are targeted for completion by 2021 and project to be awarded in 2021 is 11,712 crore rupees. projects likely to be completed during current year, which are very much important. The total projects are 28 number. Length is 651 kilometers and cost is 8,869 crores, where I am confident that we are going to complete this project this year. These projects are very important. Six-lane of Rastasthalam Anantapuram section, construction of four-lane ROV and its approaches in the Murkambattu of NH-18, four-laning of NH-9, including six-lane elevated flyover that is in new NH-65. I have got the list of all these projects, and that project cost includes is approximately, it comes to 9,000 crores. I am confident this project is going to change the scenario in the Andhra Pradesh. As far as the development in Andhra Pradesh is concerned, we are very much committed, because Andhra Pradesh is one of the progressive state and there is a huge potential for industrial development. For this year, where we are going to awarded the projects for this year, our we are now in position to award this project. The cost involves 11,712 crores of 535 kilometers. Projects number is 13. My officers from Delhi and even NHA officers, and in this meeting, my request to you that with the agenda of your state, we can resolve the problem and we will expedite the work. The post bifurcation of the state of government of Andhra Pradesh plans to develop Rayalaseema region by providing better infrastructure facilities of the making it major potential up for industrial development. Therefore, an access controlled expressway has been planned for better connectivity of capital region, coastal and northern region of Andhra Pradesh, that is Amaravati Anantapuram Express Highway. The proposed expressway connect Amaravati, new capital city of Andhra Pradesh, with Anantapuram and Rayalaseema region. It takes off from the National Highway 44 near Marur in Anantapuram district and terminates at Chikalpuria bypass near Chikalpuria in Guntur district. The proposed express highway provides a major connectivity between NH 44 and NH 16, which are lifeline in the state of Andhra Pradesh. The expressway passes through four districts: Anantapuram, Kurnool, Prakasam, and Guntur in Andhra Pradesh. This is also an important project. Once you come to Delhi, we will discuss in details about it. About the ring road of Vijayawada, Amaravati, the proposed ring road runs around the proposed capital city of Amaravati and passes through the district of Krishna and Guntur, and does fast, better movement of traffic. This project decongests the traffic of NH 16 and 65 passing through Vijayawada city. The ring road shall decongest the roads in capital city. And as far as the land acquisition is concerned, my request is, once you come to Delhi, already it was promised by the previous government for giving me 50% cost for that. But still, we will discuss the issue. If some problems, we can resolve that. That royalty on aggregate, then GST on steel and cement, you can make exemption, that can be a notional loss. And we can reduce the cost. So by which your contribution for adding of 50% of land acquisition can be reduced. But once you come to Delhi, we will discuss and we will try to resolve this problem. The total CRF sanction presently sanction according to in this year is already 681 crore rupees works have already started, already sanctioned. And when you comes to Delhi, we with the presence of the concerning officers, we will sit together. And if there is any provision for me to give more sanction, I will definitely try to give it. Regarding today's one of the important flyover, I got opportunity to visit there. That Vijayawada Durga flyover is very good. It is a pride for the country. I remember when Honorable Vice President of India, Venkaiah Naidu. At that time, he was the Urban Development Minister. In his presence, I visited the spot. I also go to that Mandir, Mata Mandir at that time, Durga Mata Mandir. And I understand the importance of this flyover. The Vijayawada MP is also making follow-up for this flyover many times to me. It is really a pleasure and pride for me that today we are completed this flyover. This is going to be one of the important flyover. The other projects are very important. About the accidents, I will request you, road accidents. Every year in the country, we have 5 lakhs accidents and 1,50,000 deaths. In Andhra Pradesh, already on National Highway, 435 black spots have been identified. Temporary rectification measure completed for 295 black spots. Permanent rectification measures completed for 150 black spots. And temporary rectification measures for balanced black spots targeted for completion in 2020. The permanent rectification measures for balanced black spots is targeted for completion by December 2021. My request to you that please give highest priority for how we can save the life of the people. We have to reduce the number of accidents. This is very important. The Tamil Nadu government successfully reduced the road accidents and death by 25%. My humble request to you and your colleagues, cabinet colleagues, and Home Ministry, that if you can plan and taking measures, there is a good example of Tamil Nadu. On the same time, World Bank, ADB is now helping to us. They are ready to sanction 14,000 crore for improvement in road engineering for black spots. I am ready to support you. My suggestion is on a mission mode. If you can decide to accept this challenge and 100% resolve this issue, then that can be a great thing for the people of Andhra Pradesh. I am personally very much sensitive and I will support for this mission for you. Thanks to you and very wishes to you. Thank you very much. Namaskar.
Thank you, sir, for your kind address. And sparing the time for laying the foundation stone laying and dedication to nation of the projects and giving a complete roadmap for the development of infrastructure in the state of Andhra Pradesh. Thank you, sir. Now, may I request Sri Mahavir Singhji to pass vote of thanks on this occasion. Member NHAI, Mr. Mahavir Singhji.
Honorable, am I audible?
Hello.
Yes. Thank you, sir. Honorable Union Minister for Road Transport and Highways and Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises, Sri Nitin Gadkari ji, Honorable Chief Minister, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu, Honorable Union Minister of State for Road Transport and Highways, General Dr. V.K. Singh ji, Honorable Union Minister of State for Home Affairs, Sri G. Krishna Reddy Garu, Honorable Minister for Roads and Buildings, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Sri M. Sankaranarayan Garu, Honorable Members of Parliament, Legislative Assembly, Legislative Council, distinguished guests on the dais, and ladies and gentlemen. I deem it a great privilege to propose vote of thanks to all the dignitaries who have graced this occasion of foundation stone laying, dedication to the nation ceremony of 61 highway projects, national highways, state roads under CRIF with investments of rupees 15,592 crore having length of 1,411 kilometer. Today's function has been an abiding commitment to the welfare of the people and development of the state of Andhra Pradesh. We are deeply grateful to the Honorable Union Minister Sri Gadkari ji for gracing this occasion for an enlightening address and sharing the vision of road infrastructure development so vital for achieving the economic and social goals for the country. I take this opportunity to Sir, your presence in this function has immensely enhanced its importance. I also thank to all honorable MPs, MLCs and MLAs for gracing this occasion. I also wish to express my gratitude to respected Secretary MORTH, Sri Giridhar Nayaji, respected Chairman NHAI, Sri SS Sandhuji, and respected Principal Secretary TRNB, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Krishna Babuji. Many a thanks are also due to Sri I.K. Pandeji, DGRD, for moderating this program. Lastly, my thanks to all the officers, including Sri R.K. Singh, RO NHAI, Sri S.K. Singh, RO MORTH, and Sri V. Ramachandra, Chief Engineer, NHCRF, RNB, the project directors, officers from R&B department, officers in the office of Honorable Minister RT&H, officers in the office of Honorable CM, Government of Andhra Pradesh, who have worked with great dedication to make this program a great success. Thank you very much once again, and Jai Hind.